This is my neighbor. My neighbor from 1950. We used to live down the street together.
Right.
So tell me why you're here today.
He left me in the ghetto.
So why are you here today?
I'm here for this men's conference. I guess probably it said conference. That's one of the things. Yeah.
What do you hope to gain from this?
Big point.
What do you hope to gain from this experience?
Oh, they're just going
to
go probably some of the things I might already know, but they want to tell you how to be a real man.
All right.
That's going to be
That's all right.
And what you tell me, why are you here today?
Well, I'm here to build up my personal house, my family house, my church house, and my community house.
All right.
That's what I'm here for.
All right.
Yeah, and God to be glorified. That's it. That's it. That's what I'm here for.
Mr. Green.
Yes, sir.
Why are you here today?
I'm just here because I know the Spirit of God is here, and for these fantastic men, try to get a hold of that word.
All right, Deacon, why are you here?
I'm here to try to, this is an occasion to try to motivate the brothers to be together and to motivate the get Christ throughout the neighborhood and throughout the uplift the name of Christ throughout the neighborhood and throughout the city and community. I'm here to see that, to attempt to spread the word of Christ through the brothers.
Yeah. I'm here today to learn a little bit more about Jesus and God, and also get the men together to work together in this country and get things organized. As a country, as a people, I think we could do a lot better. And I really like to see all these, I'm really in charge of seeing all these men. I know we're here for a reason, to make life better for all of us and for our families, and not to complain so much, but get down and work together and get all these problems straightened out, because as men, as we look as God is for our answer, we can do it. It also says in the Bible that one comes together, we all will work together to, you know, solve all these problems we have.
For the train to Jordan, picking up passengers from coast to coast. Faith is the key. Open the doors and board up, 'cause there's room for all amongst those love the most. People, get ready for the train to Jordan. It's picking up passengers from coast to coast. It's
of impressive things that go on here in San Antonio, and I've seen a lot of impressive things throughout my career in the different cities that I've been in. But I can tell you, to come on a Saturday morning and see all of you gathered here in front of all these distinguished men of the clergy is very, very impressive to me.
One of the reasons why I believe so much in this Family Life Center, even for our men's conference event that we're having today, you can turn this facility into a totally different type of facility. One day it's a basketball court. Today it's the host for a luncheon for 1,000 men for this Man Up for Jesus men's conference. Other days it can be a facility for weddings. Other days it could be you can get a bunch of kids on the floor and put out a bunch of tables, and it could be, you know, an after school program. It could be a graduation. And that's why I'm convinced now that I must build this type of facility in my hometown of New Orleans. That's my next vision, and that's what we're excited about.
Sometimes you feel like you have nowhere to turn. Sometimes it seems as though trouble is gonna last forever. But sometimes it seemed like you felt like you never were gonna make it out of the situations that you're in. But ain't God good? Sometimes it seems like nothing will ever change and go your way. But ain't God good? Thought you wasn't gonna make it through certain situations, but you did anyway. Ain't God good? Sometimes it seems like man will let you down, but God is forever keeping a watch above his own. Ain't God good? And there are times that you turn to your relatives and friends and loved ones, and they don't even have the time to spend with you. But ain't God good? Found myself at the nursing home one Friday afternoon visiting my grandmama. And as I looked around, I saw so many people sad and lonely and all alone. Because it seems like when you get old, folk just forget about you. And they just push you on the side. But somehow you're still able to hang on. And it's not up to the nursing home when it's your time to leave. Ain't God good? And I don't care what you have going on in your life. All you have to do is just hold on to God's unchanging hand. If you don't believe me, just look around. A lot of us think Barack can make everything change, but Barack can't do it all, y'all.
Ain't God good? When he walked out on stage that night and accepted the nomination to become a candidate for the presidency of the United States, I kept wishing and hoping in my heart that everything would be all right. But ain't God good? Never thought I'd be around to see something like this happen in America. To see changes come about. When one could be judged by the character and not by the color of his skin. But ain't God good? Never thought I would be around to see all of this transpiring in America like it has. But ain't God good? Sometimes when it seems like somebody just push you aside and forget about you, you always manage to hang on. But ain't God good?
We are here to for this conference for the men, so to get some support, some unity in this community with these kids.
Why are you here today, sir?
I'm here to worship with some of the brothers that I don't know, but like to me, fellowship with them, learn as much as I can from them so I can be a better person.
Ain't God good? Yeah.